Well, it's like kind of the power carry thing from the last game, cool. With the info I gathered with you, we have lots of great leads now, though. Mario, like I always said, every myth contains a kernel of truth. Speaking of which, know what was in the chest that the professor discovered? You're totally not gonna believe me when I tell you it. It's a secret, ha 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 ha. But I'll tell you the next time I see you. Oh, what's Coops up to? Oh, she actually visits these places, like, on foot. As part of my research, I did go back to many of the places we visited. And I saw everyone we traveled with, too. Coops is living peacefully in Petalburg with his dad and Koopy-Koo. And Mario, guess what Coops wants to do now? He wants to become mayor of Petalburg and live there in peace. Can you imagine? Still, it might just be perfect for him, come to think of it. He's so much more than an adult now than when you left Rokeport. Still, I think Koopy-Koo pretty much has him wrapped around her little finger. What the hell? Were you in a fight? Oh wow, it's Flurry's stage thing. Flurry's back on stage in a big way and the crowds are totally ecstatic. Oh, don't tell me, it's dupless Mario. And the play she's doing right now is the story of our adventure. Yeah. It's called Paper Mario. I saw it twice. It was totally the best play ever. Oh my god. And somehow Dupless has joined the troupe as an actor. Who saw that coming? Hey, why didn't he scan me? His transformation skills are serving him well, but it still kind of creeps me out. I wonder if those toads are actually helping him too. That would be pretty cool to have the toad as a party member. Oh, and there's Shredder. Oh, and little Shredder? Yeah, he's fighting Solo in the Glitz Pit. He says he's getting pretty close to a title match, even. Isn't that just adorable? Oh yeah, he's calling himself the Great Gonzalez Jr. in the ring, by the way. It's sort of silly, but kind of cute, too, don't you think? Oh, and wait, I've got to get this exactly right or he'll get, like, so mad at me. He, said that he could totally take you in the ring now, so bring it. I guess he doesn't change. Isn't that too cute? And I keep saying he's cute, but I could take him in the ring. I could take... Well, if his name was Tyson, that would have been awesome. I could take Tyson in the ring. I could take Shredder in the ring. Vivian's gone back to hang out with her sisters. Family is important, after all. She learned no lesson whatsoever, I guess. Now that the Shadow Queen has been defeated, I don't think Beldum's into evil. Oh, and Beldum also promised me she would never be mean to Vivian ever again. Yeah, because promises are, like, pinky swear. Come on, you can't avoid that. You can't break that promise. Yep, I think the three sirens are gonna live pretty peacefully from now on. But you should totally go visit her sometime. And what's that old sea dog up to? Wow, he's sailing with Cortez? Him and two crew members, okay. Some crew they got there. I guess they're going to Kiyoki to join the other crew. Bobbery goes out to sea every day from now on with Cortez. I think his soul is healed. I ran into him on Kiyoki by accident the other day, which was nice. He was so happy, I thought he was gonna blow up for me for a second there. Ew. You know, I bet Scarlet is looking down at him smiling right now. Oh, I almost forgot. Everyone on Kiyoki is well, and they say hello. Miss Mouse is still running the bed shop in Rokeport, so she's happy. She comes out over to Frankly's sometimes to visit. But as usual, as soon as she sets foot outside the shop, she turns into a badge ninja. She said just the other day that she had found some super rare badge, actually. That's our globe-trotting, mystery-making, flirting little badge thief, huh? And she puts on her disguise and she goes off, scaling the houses. Oh man, look at Grotus and Crumpin' though. How did Crump get there? I thought he was freaking launched into space. And okay, Grotus can talk without a head, or a body, I guess. Oh yeah! In my travels, I heard a rumor that Lord Crump and Grodus were still alive. I guess that makes them pretty tenacious baddies, doesn't it, Mario? But they mellowed a lot, just like Belden has, and I don't expect any more trouble. And they're all giving them salute, and I guess Crump is laughing at him, so I guess Crump will become the leader. Plus, I hear Grodus is just ahead, which really cuts down on mischief-making. Ooh, and what's this? Oh, it's that little transport to the moon base. I guess someone's safe there. Speaking of miracle survivals, guess whose favorite calculating computer here is here. He says he really wants to see you and Peach again. Oh wow, so Tech survived! Wow, man, I guess they wanted to make it a happy ending, having no one die whatsoever except the freaking Shadow Queen. Well, I'm totally rambling at this point, so I guess I better wrap it up. I just want to say, even though things get tough, I'm grateful for our time together. And there's one more thing that I kind of weighed on me, and I never got to express to you. See, well, maybe that's best kept secret. Oh man, is every female partner in this game fall in love with Mario? He's gotta fend them off with a stick. And by stick, I mean Peach. So please say hi to Peach for me, okay?
Till we meet again, your friend, Goombella. Yeah, top that story, Luigi. Hey, that's awesome, bro. Sounds like everyone's doing great over here.
Yeah. Who could that be?
Huh?
Someone's here.
Excuse me, sirs.
Ah, it's Toadsworth, great. Oh, it's Peach. Hello, Mario. Hello, Luigi. Please allow me to apologize for coming unannounced, but... I was cleaning out the storeroom in the castle the other day, and... I found something rather amazing! Yes, Toadsworth found a treasure map. Ah, here we go again. And I'm sure it'll lead to the real treasure this time. I just know it. So, Mario, you love to look for treasure. Isn't that right? The boat's waiting for you. Like I said, here we go again. We're off to find yet another treasure. Mario's like, not again. Alright, so we're finally done with the game. The staff credits. Yes, very long game, but we're finally here. And right now showing pictures of our adventure. And you may be noticing something. Hey, why isn't there a parade? To my knowledge, this is actually the only Mario RPG that does not have a parade, or one of the few that doesn't. It's kind of weird though, because the last one had a parade, Superstar Saga had one, Super Mario RPG had one, but this one just has silhouettes walking in the background. And at least it has some nice music, and it gives like a little slideshow right here, so I really can't complain, it's pretty nice. Yeah, so, I don't know, the only thing I don't like about the ending is... The game up until that point is so easy, and then you throw out, like, two fights in a row plus the Shadow Queen, like, I don't know what they were thinking about that. They should have made the game progressively harder, but instead it was just easy, 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 mega hard. And I don't know, the Shadow Queen used to, like, kill me as a kid, but nowadays it's like, now I actually have strategy, I actually know how to fight her, so. Yeah, when you're younger, I've been bringing up the point when you're younger, you don't really have a strategy, or you just attack enemies blindly without thinking, so. Now as I've grown up, I really, like, understood how to defeat certain kinds of enemies the right way. And it's actually pretty hard to identify each, person walking in the silhouettes. Oh wow, is that Watt? Oh wow, I think that is Watt. I don't think she even made an appearance in the game. Well, there might be a different, enemy, I don't know. But right now it's actually going in order for the, by chapter. I really never noticed that, I always thought it was, like, random. Oh, Magnus von Grapple. Hey, but I don't know how Grodus came back to Earth, because didn't we launch him into space, so I guess he went around in a circle, if that makes sense. I have no idea how the universe works, but I'm pretty sure that's not it. And there's Zesty. We really never really, explored how to make recipes and stuff, because I'm not... To me, that's kind of, like, stupid. Like, the last game, they had that option, but I'm not into the whole synthesizing of items, like, in Final Fantasy or whatever. So right now we're in Glitz Pit, and we found that little Yoshi egg. There should have been like an actual chapter dedicated to the Yoshis like the last game. That's what made it really fun, but... oh well. Ah, Sir Grotus. Yes, that was kind of weird that they made Sir Grotus the... like, the boss in this... like, I don't know. The main protagonist in this game was really, like, weird, I don't know. Like, in the last game was Bowser, so it's like, okay, we gotta save Princess Peach from Bowser. In this game, it kind of, like, throws you in for a loop, and there's so many twists and turns that you don't even know who the enemy is the whole time. Like, Bowser is, but he's not. I don't know, it's kind of weird. Aw, poor Vivian. Yeah, but back to my point from the last part, I think that every girl party member in the game had a crush on Mario for some reason. I don't know, I think it is true. I don't know, it's kind of weird that they did that. I don't know why, but... it's kind of creepy thinking about it. That all those different creatures, like, liked Mario, I don't know. Bestiality! Aw, man. Aw, Cortez, he was a cool boss. I liked him. He was probably one of my favorites. And that would have been a pretty epic showdown right there, if that super bomb didn't go off. Oh, and there's the Syndicate. Now, I have no idea how they got the mob through on past the sensors. I have no idea. And of course, our favorite non-playing person, Pennington. Yeah, Pennington would have been a cooler party member if they had a party member for, yeah, they didn't even have a party member for that chapter. Pfft, the Smorg. My least favorite boss. I don't know. They just, that chapter was just so creative and stuff, like the whole detective stuff, then they throw that. I don't know. They could have done something like at the Poshley Sanctum with the ghosts. I don't know. I don't know, I'm just spitballing. And there's that cannon of bomb. Yeah, it's funny to know that those bombs can blow themselves up and they somehow survive. I never understood how that worked. I thought it would be like more like a bee. When they sting something, they just die, but I don't know. I guess they can blow themselves up and still survive. The ultimate suicide bomber. Oh, and there's Tech. Hey, he's still alive, we figured out, and there's Hell. The portal of Hell we opened, unknowingly, as Mario would probably say. But he probably knew. He had an evil plot inside of him. Oh, Bowser on Grotus right there, God. And of course, the Shadow Queen. Not one of my favorite players in the game, or bosses, for that matter. Ah, so yes, our adventure is drawn through a close, and all rights, including the copyrights of the game, scenario, music, and program, reserved by Nintendo, of course. And this is it, the end. Ah, man, what a great game. This is probably, like I said, one of my favorite games of all time for the GameCube, and I don't know. If you don't have this game, pick it up. It's like $10 at your nearest video game store, so... you gotta pick this up. One of my favorite games of all time, and it's well-deserved to be, for that reason. Ah, so yes, this is the end. I don't really have anything much to say, so... thank you guys for watching. This is YG signing out and saying hope you enjoyed this walkthrough, and I will see you guys next time on my next playthrough and LP number 6. So see you later, guys, and thank you for watching.